رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Honorable viewers to ITV with iSoul, Alhamdulillah. We need reminders, and reminder is good for a believer. I'm touching today on a topic that is very, very close to my heart, and that we pray and make dua that Allah brings us guidance. It's known as Al-Islam wal-Unsuriyya. We are speaking about racism. What is racism? Basically, racism is to believe one race superior to another. One's color of skin to be superior to another color of skin, or the people of one country to be superior to that of another country. Now, such beliefs are pre-Islamic, is known as the days of Jahiliyyah. In Islam, we believe that all races are equal to Allah, and that the only characteristic that makes someone superior to another is righteousness. How beautifully the Almighty says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Indeed, we have favored the children of Adam. If we listen beautifully to this context, we are all, by virtue, from the same mother and same father. So Allah says, we have honored the children of Adam, وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحَرِ. And we carried you through life, on the land and in the ocean, وَرَزَقَنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. And we have blessed you with the goodness of this earth. وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ كَثِيرٍ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقَنَا تَفْضِيلًا. And we have blessed you with so much of goodness. Subhanallah. And that's the 17th surah, verse 70. So Allah created different races and tribes so that different people would recognize each other, not so that races would fight each other. In Surah 47, verse 13, Allah addresses mankind, because this Quran is not only for Muslim. This Quran is for all people till the end of time. And the Quran says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, Inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. We have created you in species, male, female. Waja'alnakum shu'uba wa qaba'ila. And we have made you into nations and tribes, لِتَعَارَفُوا, so that you exchange cultures with one another. إِنَّ أَقْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And indeed, the most honored in the sight of Allah are the one that leads a most righteous life. And that righteousness is within in oneself, that one ought to cleanse the heart and make peace with your Creator and make peace with mankind. My honorable viewers to ITV, Allah created different skin colors and languages as a sign of His creative powers. Surah Rum, Surah 30, verse 22, chapter 30, verse 22, وَمِنْ آيَاتِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ. Allah says, from my beautiful making, from my beautiful wonders, are the creation of the heavens and the earth, and the alternation, the different various various languages that are being spoken on earth. Wa alwanikum, and the variety of colors of nations and tribes. These are indeed signs for people of knowledge. And what the final prophet had to leave behind for us, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْضَةٍ. He explained to us how Allah created the first human being. Allah Ta'ala created him from a handful of the dust of the earth. And henceforth came the children of Adam in accordance with the earth. The colors of the earth, the texture of the earth, red skin, white skin, dark skin, and whatever is in between. And then the different temperaments of man because of the different colors of soil and the different temperaments of soil. There's easygoing, there's those that are a little bit sad, and there are those that are cool, and there are those that are a little bit not so cool. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left this message for us. He said, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people, know well, inna rabbakum wahid. Your Lord is one. There's one Lord that controls the whole system of life. Ala la fadla li arabi ala ajami. I am teaching you today something that's of key, that's of utmost importance. There's no virtue of an Arab over a foreigner, nor of a foreigner over an Arab. Subhanallah. And he said further, and there's no virtue of a red skin to that of a dark skin, and nor of a dark skin over that of a red skin, except with taqwa, your consciousness, your own self, your finding your connection with your Creator Allah. Did I convey? And his entire congregation, the companions, all said, Bala ya Rasulullah, indeed you have conveyed. This honorable Hujjaj, those who has already went for pilgrimage, you will witness on Muzdalifah, you will witness on the day of Arafah. What do you see on Muzdalifah for a South African? You see the entire Ghana, Nigeria, you see the Sudan, Chad, Malawi, Mali, the whole of Africa. You are surrounded amongst them. So what does that show you? That shows you exactly what the Prophet ﷺ came to teach us, that we are all one unit, brotherhood, connected to our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want you to just note and listen very carefully on an episode. This is but one amongst quite a lot. When Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu al-Ghifari, he once said to Bilal, and as we know, Bilal, he was an Abyssinian slave, and his freedom was bought. And when he embraced Islam, there was no religion per se much more beautifully to him to make him feel amongst the greater masses of mankind, to make him feel in amongst all the color, the rainbow color of people, to be conscious of Allah. That he was the first man that Islam chose to be calling people to Allah by virtue of calling people on the, like we call on the mic, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. God is the greatest, God is the greatest. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness there's none to worship but God. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. I bear witness that there's a messenger. Like all messengers came and left, the Prophet is the final of all messengers. Hayya ala salah. Come, O people, leave everything behind and come for prayer. Hayya ala al falah. Therein lies your success. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allah is great, Allah is great. La ilaha illallah. Don't worship anything but God. Bilal, Allah blessed him to be the first one from Abyssinia, dark-skinned, but he came to honor Islam. The voice of Bilal was even heard in paradise when the Prophet ﷺ returned and said, Oh Bilal, what is that special that I hear of you? Your footsteps in Jannah. And Bilal was honored. Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu once said to Bilal, Ya bana Sauda, O son of a black woman. Bilal did not want to get into an argument. Bilal radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to seek guidance. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him what Abu Dharr just told him, O son of a black woman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to approach Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu and said, Anta alladhi tu'ayyara Bilalan bi ummihi walladhi unzila al-kitab ala Muhammad ma li ahad alayya fadlun wala bi amal antum katifi sa'. By the one who revealed the book to Muhammad, referring to the Quran to Muhammad, none is more virtuous over another except by righteous deeds. Subhanallah. This is to teach us that we as Muslims have to have utmost respect for each and every human being that Allah Ta'ala has created perfect in his and her way. And the ultimate is that consciousness of Allah, the righteousness within the soul. The Prophet ﷺ came to abolish unkindness to maids, to domestic workers, to the gardener, to the driver, to the employees. The Prophet taught his companions, أَقْرِمُوهُمْ كَكَرَامَةِ أَوْلَادِكُمْ, that honor them as you would honor your own children. أَطْعِمُوهُمْ, feed them of exactly what you eat. In other words, treat people like the way you like to be treated. The last, one of his last messages that he left before he left this world was two things. As-salah, salah. O my ummah, keep up your prayers. Ittaqullah fima malakat aymanukum. And also fear Allah regarding those under your authority. It should be as respected as human beings. Respect those domestic workers. Respect those that are working at your work. Respect the gardener, the employees, the driver. In fact, he ended off to say, "Atul ajira ajra," pay them decent wages before their sweat perspires. We make dua, inshallah, that hopefully by this advice, that in our homes, it's so important how we treat our domestic workers. When we treat them with beautiful character, and when we speak to them with good words, we see so much blessings come into our lives, and they themselves will work much better in return. May Allah Ta'ala allow us all to take the beautiful examples from the Quran and prophetic guidance from our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. رمضان هل هلاله